talk in this nice webinar. So hello, my name is Zi Yunlong. I'm the assistant professor. I'm probably the most young here. So from the Chinese University of Hong Kong. So I joined the CUHK from the 2017. So this is my fourth year. Okay, so today I'm going to talk about my research about the capturing energy through the triboelectric nanogenerator and the self-powered wireless sensing system. So, well, apparently what we are talking about is related to the energy issue. And, you know, as the fossil fuel is going to be exhausted after several decades. So we did a lot of study about how to obtain energy from the renewable energy resources. And especially when we are talking about for the Internet of Things. So we are actually talking about for the trillions of different kinds of devices mounted in every corner of the society, right? So in that highly distributed devices, then there is one problem, that is how could we have the highly distributed power sources? And traditionally we can use the battery, right? But the battery, they have limited lifetime. Then you need to have a lot of issues on the maintenance, on the replacement. And then what we are thinking is probably we can harvest energy from the ambient environment, from the renewable energy resources, so that we can power the battery so that at least they can have an extended lifetime. Or if possible, we can possibly have the more sustainable solution, that is achieve a self-powered solution. Okay, so what we are working on is related to the triboelectric effect, which is very commonly in our daily life. For example, when you are shaking hands with other people, especially in the dry locations in the northern area, right? So sometimes while you get an electrical shock because your hands could bring some tribal charges. And also another example could be, for example, the rubber balloon can have some tribal charge, which can attract small objects such as hails. Okay, and also it's believed that the thunders and lightning is related, also related to tribal electrical effect in the cloud. But for a long-term study, tribal electric effect was considered as a negative effect because it can make an electrical breakdown to the air, to the dielectric material, and also to the devices and the circuits. And that's why people did a lot of study on how to avoid tribal electric effect. But today I'm going to talk about how to utilize the tribal electric effect. Well, why? Because it contains energy. Think about that. If we have the two hands, right, you have the triboelectric effect, then it's take separated. How much energy you can bring with this structure? Well, I did a calculation. The electrical potential energy is about 18 millijoule. What do we can do with 18 millijoule? So we can power a humidity meter for over 30 minutes. We can power an LED bulb for 30 minutes, and we can power a calculator for 15 minutes. That's why we are working on such a triboelectric nanogenerator device, or we call it as a TNG. Okay, the reason we call it as the nanogenerator is because it's relatively smaller than the regular generator. And it's just like the nano satellites to the satellite. It just means smaller satellites, but that's not necessarily to be nanometer size. And besides, the reason we call it a nanogenerator is because we want to make it distinguished with the regular generator, which was made from the electromagnetic induction. Okay, so the TNG, right? TNG is mainly due to the triboelectric effect coupling with the electrostatic induction. So as shown in this quick demonstration, you can see when the two different material get a contact, you have the triboelectric effect, right? And then as the backhand of force movement, so you have the electrostatic induced voltage to drive the current backhand force. So you have the AC output. And this video will show you okay, the TNG can actually power tens of LED bulbs, and the size is like only finger size. Okay, that's why people did a lot of research in recent years on how to harvest energy from water waves, wind, body motion, and how to power portable wearable devices, wireless transmission, and even the implanted medical devices. Okay, so let me only mainly talk about the research after I joined COHK. So after I joined COHK, well, I think a lot about the research topic of the TNG. So one thing is, you know, they have really high output voltage, and then we should have more basic understandings on the why they have this, such a special output characteristics. And secondly, we have to find the technical roads for applications. Okay, and so that we did some research on these two aspects. So one is about the basic understandings on the triboelectric mechanism, discharge behaviors, dynamic performance, and then the technical roads related to the energy conversion, the wireless sensing, high voltage applications. So here I would like to just share a few examples. Okay, so the first topic I'm going to talk about is the mechanism of the triboelectric effect. You know, when the two different materials get a contact, one take positive, one take a negative, that's triboelectric effect. But different people, different scientists, they keep propose a different model for that. Okay, so some researchers talk about, okay, it is mainly about the electron transfer. That is because the electron can jump from one material to another material when they are in contact. So that with additional electron, that's negative. With a few electrons, that's positive. Okay, so that's the electron transfer mechanism. But some people proposed, that could be the ion transfer on the surface. Okay, or could be some material that which takes a charge transfer. Okay, so how could we do the research on the mechanism of triboelectric effect? Well, we should keep thinking about what is the really characteristics we can reflect after the charge transfer. Well, what we are thinking is that's one question, okay? After the triboelectric effect, why the tribal charge can stay on the surface? Okay, that is because in the surface, there is a certain potential barrier that prevents the charge goes away. Okay, so then from the thermionic emission, the planar emission or the field emission, so any characteristical tools, we can actually characterize what is the barrier heat. Okay, and we believe this is barrier is different for different materials and different materials surfaces. Okay, so what we can do, we are thinking, is we can did a study on the barrier heat W. Okay, and because it is reflect what is material the charge will stay on, so that if we know which material is in, then we know what is the triboelectric charge transfer mechanism. Okay, so here we propose our hypothesis. When we have two different material get a contact, okay. So if it is an electron transfer, that means the material A will donate some electrons goes to the material B. Right? Then during the thermionic emission, for example, what we measure the W should be for the material B, right? Okay. But if it is a material or ion transfer, okay, since it's more complicated, well, at least some material A will residues on the material B should contain some electrons. So that during this thermionic emission measurement, you should measure the W for the material A at least, or just all mix between the A and B. Okay, so from the W, we can actually compare with the different material system and know something about the triboelectric mechanism. So we designed the experimental setup. Basically, we use the TNG and the measurement system placed inside the oven so that for the thermionic emission. So basically, we can see at a higher temperature, the charge, surface charge will get discharged quickly. And after stable, you can see it is follows the thermionic emission. And then we can did the Lorentz scale and did the linear fit on the Lorentz scale so that you can find a slope, and this slope will be related to the W value on the surface. Okay, so that is the material, the method we demonstrated. Okay, and then we can utilize to do the calculation for various kinds of the material pairs. Okay, so I can separate it into two groups. One group is a metal polymer. As you can see, for different metals as a material A and polymers as material B, you can see, as always, the W value measured is always related to the material B, right? It's not related to material A. So that's why we think the metal polymer triboelectrification is mainly due to the electron transfer mechanism. Okay, but if you are comparing for different polymer and polymer charges, okay, then the things are quite different. Okay, you can see sometimes it's close to the W from the material A, and sometimes close to material B, and then sometimes between them, and sometimes it's even after them. So there are still a lot of things to study, but one thing we can confirm, it is highly material pair dependent charge transfer. Okay, it could include the electron transfer, could have the material transfer or ion transfer. So we are still working on that and on how to more quantified study about the ratio between the different charge transfer mechanism. Okay, and then let me talk about the discharge issue. Okay, so then the first question is why it can have the breakdown discharge from the tribal charge. Okay, from the quick simulation, you can see the voltage of generated by the TNG can actually up to 90 kilovolts. I believe it could be 100 kilovolts, okay? And well, at the same time, the charge generated them is very small, it's usually smaller than one microcoulomb. So why it is that? Well, simply we can use the V equal to Q over C to explain that. That is because we have the relatively small capacitance. So if we have the small capacitance of like a pKf level, then it is very easily to generate volts over kilovolts level. Okay, that's why it is very easy to generate a breakdown discharge. Okay, so here is a theoretical study I did on the breakdown effect. Basically, I used the voltage between the two triboelectric surfaces as V1 as compared to the breakdown voltage as calculated from the Parsons law, okay, Vb. So we make a subtraction between the two. Then if the final result is positive, then everybody happy, it's non-breakdown. And if it is negative, then it means it has breakdown. We should give a warning sign. But this is a purely theoretical. And how could we demonstrate experimentally, right? So we consider that and design such a kind of measurement system. Okay, so we are using a charging TNG, relatively large TNG, to generate a large enough voltage to charge for the test TNG. Okay, at the same time, we measure the charge transfer and the voltage in the same time. Okay, so this circuit is used for the high voltage measurement, because if you are using just a common electrical meter, you know, it is limited by the voltage range. You cannot go to that high voltage, right? So this is the best way. And we designed a process flow, and then you can see every time when there is a breakdown discharge spark here, there will be a turning point in the measurement circuits in the VQ plot, so that, well, we can confirm this is a breakdown behavior. Okay, so now we can do the measurement and collect all the turning points as breakdown points, and then plot it into the VQ plot of the TNG, so that we can actually make them two line. You can see it can distinguish the total VQ area into two areas. One is the breakdown area, another one is the non-breakdown area. Okay, so this is the measurement circuit. As you can see, it is very consistent. Every time where there's a spark, there's a turning point. And this is actually a capture breakdown spark by the high-speed camera, so that we can confirm it is a breakdown effect. So that after we know that, we can actually distinguish the breakdown area and the non-breakdown area, and then we can make a correction on the evaluation standards for the TNG. Okay, so basically, you know, previously the evaluation is basically how maximum energy we can have from the TNG, right? But now we should consider the breakdown area so that we only should consider the effective maximum energy that is in the non-breakdown area so that we can make a new figure of merits to compare with the different TNG structures. And also we can calculate what is the energy output density by the effective maximized energy for different structures of TNG and make it compared to the other technology, for example, piezoelectric and electromagnetic study, so that we can know better how much energy output we can achieve in our TNG. Okay, and also at the same time, after understanding the breakdown behaviors, we can also design this in some environment, we can suppress such a breakdown. For example, in the high pressure with the lower mean free path for the electrons so that the electron cannot accumulate enough energy to break down the air molecules. So that with that, we can actually increase the energy density by 3 to 30. Times, okay, with the great increase of the energy output, okay? So these are just fundamental studies. So let me talk about some application studies. Well, let me firstly talk about the concept of me. I want to demonstrate, you know, the TNG is very easy to have the high voltage. Then the high voltage means the high impedance. And in that case, if we are directly connected to the devices mostly have the low impedance, that will be huge impedance mismatch that will make extremely low efficiency. Okay, so a common way to solve that is through the power management circuit, PM circuit, okay, to make the impedance a little bit lower for the output. It is more compatible with the devices, so the efficiency could be enhanced. But you know, with additional circuits or additional devices, you are actually bringing additional energy consumption, right? So that there is still limited overall efficiency with that. And then you bring additional cable connections, okay, which is not very good. So what I propose to do is two ways, okay? You can firstly, you can utilize the controlled high voltage output to directly drive the devices that should be driven by the high voltage, okay? Or alternatively, you can, if you are using the high voltage for sensing performance, you can utilize the signals converted into the electromagnetic wave or optical signals, and then wireless emitting out so that you can use a receiver to receive them for the further process, okay? So that it is more possible to achieve the self-powered systems, okay? So let me talk about the self-powered wireless sensing for the infrastructure first, I think, as an example. Okay, so this is the Hong Kong Zhuhai and Macau Bridge. So this is the proud of the country. Okay, but you know, for the huge bridge, you need to monitor its vibrations. Okay, especially if, for the huge vibration, it may induce the crash of the bridge. Okay, so how to monitor the vibrations? You should have a lot of sensors, especially the wireless sensors, placed in the every many places of the bridge, right? And it is preferred to have wireless because we want to reduce the cost in the maintenance and replacement. And then what the question is, how could we achieve the self-powered wireless sensing? Okay, so we propose one way we can utilize the TNG to drive an optical devices. For example, here we demonstrated an optical switch, which is what's inside is oil mixed with the solution. So that if it is in a normal status, there's no TNG triggering. It is just a flat interface between the oil and the solution, so that it is just a transparent lens, okay, so that the optical signal can directly go through that, okay. And if it is under the high voltage signal due to the electrostatic forces, it will become a concave lens so that optical light will be dispersed, okay. So that, such a change of the concave lens can be reflected by the aspect ratio by the height of the lens. As you can see, if you can achieve over the 200 volts, you can actually change its aspect ratio. and higher, you get a higher change. This is a demonstration of the change of the high aspect ratio of the interface, okay? And so that we can design our optical system. You can see you can utilize a laser to point into a mirror and reflect the bed, go into the optical switch and go back to detector. If there's no motion or vibration, you can see the detector can detect such a laser so that, there's no such a vibration. If you have enough vibration or motion, then the optical switch will be dispersive so that the detector cannot receive the laser light signal, okay? And the more important thing is, you can see for this right part, this is totally self-powered. You don't need to use any battery. You don't need to use any cables here. That is very suitable for the remote sensing. Okay, so here is a demonstration. We can utilize to demonstrate the stepping. Okay, so as you can see, stepping on, siren on, stepping off, siren off, stepping on again, siren on again. And probably you want to ask, okay, it's still not very convenient. You should have a very well aligned the detector to detect the optical signal. So we have made an improvement, okay? So basically we have added the color tuning system because the color tuning is more easily to be detected, okay? We have this color tuning plate, okay? If it's not in a normal state, it is concentrated in the center, then it is titanium oxide, so it's just transparent, so the color won't be changed too much. If it is dispersive, it will go to the red phosphor material here, okay? So it will be mainly converted to a red signal. Then you should have an alarm. And more importantly, the color change can be easily captured by regular devices, for example, the camera in your cell phone. And then with an app, you can do the analysis on your cell phone directly, okay? So here is the effect we have demonstrated. You can see it is a very clear color change with a relatively large as a color distance. And it can be utilized not only for the vibration, but also possibly for the wind speed detection, also possibly for the smart car, for the vehicle speed detection, so you can avoid a collision, and also possibly for the ocean and underwater detection, you can utilize for the smart illumination, okay? So that's one possible application. And another thing I'd like to share is through the electromagnetic wave. You know, traditionally, if you want to utilize the energy harvester, including TNG, to power the wireless sensing, well, you need actually multiple modules. You know, you need a sensing, the signal modulation, the wireless transmission, and even the power and management separately. Okay, but here we utilize a new technology. We use a rapid discharge technology for the triple charge so that we can achieve fabricate everything together in a small pieces of devices. So that's all-in-one self-powered wireless sensing e-sticker. Okay, or we call it as a SWICE. So it can be sticked into many places. And it is thin, and it is small in size, and it is even flexible, okay? And then so that we can use just like a hand sliding to generate a wireless signal of megahertz, okay? And then you can see it's transmitted in anywhere, and compared to other technology, we are small in size, and also it can maintain in a high effective transmission distance. So it will be very good for self-powered wireless sensing applications. So here is a demonstration. As you can see, the small pieces, no battery, no cables. We can transmit, generate, and transmit the wireless signal to transmit it for over 10 meters. And then here's other demonstration. This is for the small version, so it can still works, but with a relatively smaller transmission distance, but it's still working, okay? And this is for the multi-sensing, multiple sensing. You can see if you can be made as the keyboard, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 can be distinguished and detected by the computer wirelessly. And this is a wearable version as a wristband. Okay, so here is another application for the wireless sensing. I also have some other recently demonstrated applications, but time is limited. So let me just quickly go through. Okay, so here is a color tunable film. Okay, so basically we use the tribal induced electroluminescence. A characteristic is, you know, if you have the slightest sliding, you have a red color. If you have a sliding, you have turns into green color. Okay, so it will can be utilized for the increased secure system for your cell phone and lock system. Okay. This is the tribal-induced smart window. Basically, we can utilize the wind to drive the TNG, and then we can make the liquid crystal on and off, okay? And this is the inverse version. Basically, one tribal charge, you can utilize for a relatively long time for off of the smart window. And then you can turn it off also very easily by instantaneously hand wiping, okay? This is the tribal charge induced face mask. You know, we are doing everything against the COVID-19. And I believe the face mask, which can have a extended lifetime, will be very important for the face mask. And currently we have utilized that for the over 2 days. So it is still very effective to attract the small particles. Okay. So some of my research, I have contributed many basic understanding on the triboelectric electrification and the TNG devices, including the tribal charge and discharge. Okay, and also I demonstrated the technological roles for the TNG high voltage applications, including smart windows, wireless sensing, and other things. Okay, with that, I have achieved many papers, publications, and a lot of citations, and with some other achievements. Okay, so here I would like to acknowledge my postdocs and students, as they really work very hard. You know, Hong Kong is quite a tough time in the past 2 years, actually. So they really work very hard. Otherwise, I cannot have so many achievements. And thank you so much from the funding grants, from the government, from the institute, and from the company, and from the university. Okay, thank you so much. And I appreciate any questions or comments.